check this out.
Akbar Birbal, Akbar Birbal, Akbar Birbal. Akbar Birbal, Akbar Birbal, Akbar Birbal. Akbar Birbal, Akbar Birbal, Akbar Birbal. Akbar Birbal, Akbar Birbal, Akbar Birbal.
Occasionally, Emperor Akbar felt like testing Birbal's wit. One fine day, seeing that Birbal was coming towards him, Akbar started feigning illness.
I'm finding it very difficult to survive now.
My lord, what is happening to you? Are you feeling any pain?
Please save me from this pain. I don't want to live like this.
What is happening, my lord? Why are you talking like this?
Since morning, I'm having extreme pain in my chest. Oh God! And I'm also draining of my all strength.
Relax, relax. I'll get the doctor right away.
He has already visited me in the morning.
Okay. Then are you not getting any relief from his medicines?
No.
Then let me go and get another doctor, my lord.
First, I have to get the medicine for it to have effect on me.
What? That medicine is not available?
No.
Okay, then we will get it from another state. Somewhere we should be able to get it.
Who knows whether we'll get it or not. Allah, take me away. Take me away soon, Allah.
Your Highness, please do not lose hope so easily. I'll get this medicine for you. Tell me what medicine it is.
The doctor has...
Yes?
For a month...
Yeah, go on.
...asked me to drink bull's milk. Bull's milk, Birbal.
Hearing of bull's milk, Birbal realized that Akbar was trying to make fun of him. But he did not show it to the emperor and said,
"Oh, that's very simple, my lord. Just give me 2 days' time. We have many bulls in our kingdom. One of them must surely be giving milk, my lord. I will get you this bull's milk in 2 days' time."
Okay. Until then, I'll not lose hope. Oh God. Allah.
After consoling the emperor, Birbal came home and started thinking. His daughter Tejaswini saw Birbal's worried face and asked him the reason of his concern. Birbal then told Tejaswini of the new responsibility given by Akbar to him. Then Tejaswini said,
"So, this time you're not able to come up with a plan, is it? If you wish, should I suggest a plan to you? That is the reply to be given to the emperor."
I do have a plan. But for that, I need your help, Tejaswini. But I'm thinking as to how to tell you about that work, my child.
Whatever it is, you tell me. I'll definitely help you. I would really like to help you.
Okay, then listen.
My lord, a woman is waiting outside to meet you. She wants to give you some good news.
Okay, send her inside.
My lord, please accept this sweet. I can't see Mr. Birbal anywhere today. Where has he gone?
Achoo! He has gone out of state.
Okay, it's all right.
Hey young one, who are you? And why are you distributing these sweets?
My lord, we have some good news in our house.
Good news? Tell me.
Ish. So, I am going to become a mother in 8 days.
Mother in 8 days? But you don't look pregnant at all.
That is the beauty of it. That is why I am distributing sweets today itself.
Hey, listen you. Tell me the fact very clearly.
My lord, I am going to become a mother in 8 days. But I will not be giving birth to the child. My husband will.
What?
Sir, our child is in my husband's stomach.
What do you think? I'm a fool? You think I'll accept whatever you tell me? Can a man ever become pregnant?
I don't know, my lord. I'm not yet married, you see. Have you ever become pregnant before?
My lord, if you don't believe me, then I will call him immediately. He is standing outside.
Just look at him.
Oh God.
How can this be possible?
Please help God.
Is this ever possible?
See, my lord, my husband is going to give birth in 8 days. I hope you believe me now.
But how is this possible? Where in the world does a man ever give birth?
Why not, my lord? If a bull can give milk in our kingdom, then a man can also get pregnant, can't he?
Well, Birbal, I'm very pleased with this reply of yours. Here, take this 100 coins.
My lord, please share this gift.
Huh?
Because she too played a big part in this.
Okay, but who is she?
I am Birbal's daughter, my lord. Tejaswini.
Is it? Here, take your gift.
And this is our child.
Once a poor Brahmin knocked on the door of a wealthy person and said,
"Is anyone there?"
"Who are you? I do not recognize you."
"My lord, I am a traveler going to Kashi on pilgrimage. Now while the sun is setting, I have reached your city. So you please give me shelter in your house tonight. At the crack of dawn, I'll leave towards my destination."
The owner took pity on the poor Brahmin and he said at once,
"Oh, come in, please come in. I have no problem at all. I'll get a chance to serve you. I consider these to be my honor."
"Wow, how generous you are. May your 7 generations be prosperous."
The owner gave shelter to the Brahmin in his house. He fed him properly and gave him a separate room to sleep. Tired of walking through the day, the Brahmin soon fell asleep. Those days, robberies had been on the increase in Delhi. The government had also increased patrolling at night.
Keep awake! Keep awake! Keep awake! Keep awake!
Unfortunately, one of the patrolling police himself was stealing and taking the loot to his house. The thief broke the wall of the room which was given by the owner to the Brahmin to sleep and moved slowly towards a closed box in that room. Police opened the box and checked and found expensive jewelry in that. He immediately took the box and started leaving. While leaving, his leg touched the sleeping Brahmin. Brahmin caught hold of the leg immediately and started shouting, "Thief! Thief!" The thief told the Brahmin,
"Leave! Hey Brahmin, leave my leg or else..."
"No, no, no! I have been given shelter here. The owner's problem is my problem. I will not allow you to go away from here. Run, run, help!"
From his talk, the thief understood that the Brahmin was a guest in that house. He lured the Brahmin by saying,
"There is a lot of jewelry in this chest. We will go out and split this equally."
"No, no. I can never do such a weak thing. And you are in a uniform of a soldier and you are yourself stealing."
When the thief realized that he will be blamed for the robbery, he started shouting loudly,
"Hello, sir! Hello, sir! Your guest has broken the wall and is getting away with the chest! See, I have caught him!"
Hearing the noise in the room, the owner came there. The police had kept the chest down and was holding the Brahmin. On seeing the owner, the policeman said,
"My lord, see, this is your thief. He was trying to run away with the chest. I've caught him."
"No, no, my lord. He is lying. He was actually trying to steal inside and I have caught him."
The owner could not believe what the Brahmin said. He felt that this Brahmin had planned and entered his house and stolen at the right opportunity. He said,
"Sad, I took pity on you and this is how you repay me? Now only the emperor will decide what is to be done with you."
The next day, the owner of the house, along with the Brahmin and the soldier, came to Akbar's palace. He explained to Emperor Akbar all that had taken place the previous night. Akbar said to Birbal,
"Birbal, let us you decide on this case."
"Okay, my lord.
Now tell me, who this man is and how did he come to your house?"
"I am a traveler on a pilgrimage to Kashi."
"Sir, upon his request, I gave him shelter, but..."
"No, my lord. This soldier broke the wall and he was running away with the chest."
He is lying. He has stolen the chest."
While this argument was taking place, when another soldier came and said,
"Jahapna, please forgive me. I am interfering in your proceedings. But my lord, my work is like that."
"Speak out."
"Jahapna, my son and myself, we went to the Hanuman temple outside the village. We were coming out after praying when my son fainted and he fell on the floor. Jahapna, I'm scared. I don't even have the courage to lift him. Kindly send two people with me."
"You don't worry about your son. I will make the necessary arrangements. You have to do an important duty here, so you don't go there. The two of you go to the Hanuman temple and bring the child here. On your return, we shall solve your problem. Understood?"
The soldier knew where the temple was. On Birbal's instructions, he took the Brahmin to the temple. They put the fainted boy in the top cloth of the Brahmin and returned. On the way back, the Brahmin told the soldier,
"You thief! Actually, you have broken the wall. You were only stealing there. Even then, in front of everyone, you accused me of stealing."
"Brahman, what you say is true. But I was ready to split the jewelry in the chest with you. But you did not listen to me. Now you suffer the consequence of being good."
Talking along the way with the child, they came to the palace. The father of the child made him lie down in a palace. He too sat over there. Now Birbal asked the two of them once again,
"Now tell me the truth. Which of the two stole the chest?"
"He did."
"Jahanpana, I'm a soldier in this kingdom. My job is to protect. How can I steal?"
"Hey protector, you are the real thief. I have heard everything that you have spoken. You broke the wall and ran off with the chest of jewels."
When the truth came to light, the courtiers were shocked. Birbal immediately pronounced a jail sentence for the soldier and he declared the Brahmin innocent. Akbar could not contain himself. He asked the second soldier,
"Tell me, your son was supposed to have fainted."
"Who fainted, my lord? In order to find the culprit, Birbal made my son lie down there and asked me to play act."
Hearing this, the emperor showered praises on Birbal. And those jealous of Birbal became more jealous of him.
"My lord, what are you doing?"
"Fool, can't you see I'm hitting Birbal?"
"But this is only a statue."
"But even the statue is of Birbal's, isn't it? How can he show his cunningness here? He is silently tolerating the pain."
What you say is true. But by hitting the statue, how can you become the minister?"
"Shut up! Instead of laughing like this, you people think something. I should be established in place of Birbal. Think of that."
"Yeah.
How is it possible? How
can we do this? I have got an idea. Got it. I have got an idea."
"So please tell me, what is in your mind?"
Okay, I'll tell you. But first you tell me, who's our city's most famous and most intelligent person?"
"Oh, the most famous means our Sher Khan."
"No, more famous than Sher Khan means Birbal." "And who is more famous than Birbal, who is known to all?"
"Our Emperor Akbar."
"Oh, somebody please shut his mouth. What are we talking about and what is he talking about?"
"If you ask me, the most famous person in the city is the Babar Hassan. Everyone knows him."
"Oh yes, how very, very clever of you. You keep on blabbering something. Talking of Hassan, I agree that everyone knows him, but is he intelligent? More intelligent than Birbal?"
"Such a man must be."
Come on, tell me, who's he?
"Such a person is Tansen."
"Very good, Tansen. Sher Khanji, now only Tansen can help us."
"How do you say that?"
Yes, Khan sir. Every time you insist to the emperor to make you the minister, and every time you lose it to Birbal."
"Yes, I know it. Why do you remind me again and again?"
This time, if you put Tansen's name up for the post of the minister,
But what will come out of this?
Aha! Tansen's knowledge is better than Birbal's, and he's smart too. If you ask him to be the minister, it will be difficult for the emperor to refuse.
Excellent, excellent! By this, we can easily remove Birbal from the post of minister.
Yes, and the stick also will die, and the snake will not break.
That's a nice idea. Now come on, let's give it a try.
Sa, sa, sa,
sa,
sa,
sa,
sa,
re,
ga,
ga,
re,
ma,
ma, re. Oh, it's you, Sher Khan.
Yes, Sir Tansen, it's me. I thought I'd learn a little of the art from a great musician like you.
I'm not great, Sher Khan. The God has given me a gift. I'm only a humble servant of the art.
Not at all, Mr. Tansen. You are truly great. There are many in this world who worship your talent. Appreciate.
Yes. If you practice the art, then fame and fortune will come by itself.
Good, good. I appreciate your ideas. You have a great knowledge, Tansen. But I feel very sad when I think about only one aspect. It has been troubling me.
Did I do anything wrong, Mr. Sher Khan?
No, no. Please don't say such things. The mistake is not yours, but ours.
I don't understand.
When a great person like you is residing in our kingdom, even though Birbal...
What Birbal? He is a very learned person.
Let it be. Where is he a learned man? By talking smart and by using new ideas, one does not become learned. Mr. Tansen, Birbal is enjoying both fame and fortune.
Will you please be brief?
All I want to tell you is, you should become the minister of our kingdom.
What? Me and minister?
Oh yes.
Friend, my world is only music. How will I suit that job? And my becoming the minister should also have the acceptance of the emperor, isn't it?
You are so great, knowledgeable. If you become the minister, then for you to sustain your music and improve your music, you'll get a new avenue. That you become minister is not just mine, but the wish of so many others too. If only your name is proposed to the emperor, he will have to think not once but 10 times.
If you are saying, I'll definitely ask the emperor.
The following day in the court, Tansen said to Akbar,
Badshah Salamat, please accept my wishes.
Tell me, Tansen, how did you think of me today?
Jahapna, you are very well aware of that I am a renowned musician. Many people in the world are fans of my art.
Yes, Tansen, you are great. And that is why you are one of the 9 gems in my palace.
But in this palace, when it comes to learning, I am the best and better known. So I should be the minister of this kingdom. This is the wish of quite a few people, my lord. I hope I am right, Mr. Sher Khan, isn't it?
Hearing Sher Khan's name, Akbar understood that it was another plan of Sher Khan's to remove Birbal from the post of the minister. Immediately, he said something in the ear of a sentry. After the sentry left, Akbar said,
I agree. Tansen's learning is definitely better than Birbal's. If he becomes the minister, then it is an honor for us. But as of now, Birbal is the minister. It is not possible to remove him that easily.
So what do we do, Jahapana?
I'll tell you. Birbal and Tansen.
Yes, my lord.
You take this letter and go to the Emperor of Iran. The one among both of you who brings me the reply will be the minister of this empire. Okay?
Accepted my lord.
Such a simple thing. I'll go right away and be back with the reply.
Your Highness, there are two men outside. They say they are being sent by the Delhi Emperor on some work.
Send them in.
Birbal and Tansen appeared before the Emperor of Iran.
Your Highness, we are sent by the Delhi Emperor Akbar. He had asked us to get a reply for this letter.
What is all this?
Your Highness, there's nothing much in it. This is a letter. Our Emperor wants a reply for this letter. So you please give the reply to me.
In this letter, it is written that the person who brings this letter should be beheaded.
On hearing about the beheading, Tansen was terrified and started perspiring. Birbal too was stunned.
See what you have done. And why should you be beheaded, I do not know. But as is expected from an emperor, I will have to behead you. Nadif, they should be beheaded at the crack of dawn. Till then, keep them as captives.
Your wish, sir.
Birbalji, do something. Save me. I mean, save both of us from this danger. You are so intelligent. You can certainly think of some idea. I don't want to become the minister. I'll never get carried away by them again.
Let it be, Mr. Tansen. Sometimes it does happen like this. Tomorrow do exactly as I tell you to.
Okay.
Stop!
What is it?
Nothing.
Stop!
Now what is it?
Nothing. You behead me first, please.
No. See, listen, first you behead me.
No. First me.
No, first me.
No, first me, myself.
Stop it, I say stop it. The Emperor will decide what is to be done with you.
Okay. Remember, do exactly what I've told you to do.
Yes, you don't worry. Yes.
Okay, tell me what is happening.
Your Highness, you have not asked us about our last wish.
What is your wish?
I should be beheaded before him.
And what is your wish?
My wish is that he should be beheaded after me.
What?
Yes, Your Highness, behead me before him.
And before that, please behead me.
Even before that, behead me.
No. Much before that, you behead me. I am telling you that you should behead
myself. Stop it. What is this new confusion now? Why are you both eager to be beheaded first?
No, we cannot tell you that. But one thing we can tell you is you better first behead me only. Yes.
No. First tell me the reason. Till then, I will not allow either of you to be beheaded.
I'll tell you. But first, release her hands.
Yes. Set their hands free.
Your Highness, we both are totally innocent. And our Emperor wishes that we should be beheaded by you.
Why such a wish?
Yes, Your Highness. It may sound weird, but it is the truth.
My Lord, our Emperor wants to win over your kingdom. But you a sinner, unjust, cruel and mean.
What did you say?
No, no, you're not. You're not.
You are very, very, very,
yes, very clean,
clever,
very pure.
And, very,
yes,
very clever. And
the matter is, our emperor had been facing many obstacles in attacking your kingdom. Your majesty, a big astrologer told him
that if you kill two innocent persons, then he can very easily attack your kingdom and rule over it, your majesty.
Yes, and you will be his prisoner.
Yes.
Our emperor is very greedy and ambitious.
Yes.
Your highness, why were these two fighting to die first?
It is like this, my lord. Before we left for this place, our teacher told us that the one who will die first will become the king of this kingdom, and the one who dies later will become the minister. And I want to be the king, your highness.
No. I want to become the king.
Stop!
Your emperor is playing dirty on me. Both of you leave immediately and tell him that to win the kingdom of a just emperor like me is not all that easy. Move on, go!
But your highness, it is so, then behead him first.
I have told you to leave this place.
Yes, let's go.
Jahapna, Birbal is the ideal person to be the minister of this kingdom. I am not fit for it by no means.
Why do you say so?
Oh, learned one, you are very knowledgeable. By now, you would have come to know what must have happened there.
I know. I know everything.
In the city of Delhi, there lived a very short-tempered man called Tadkumal. What he would do in a fit of anger, nobody knew. One day, this Tadkumal got angry on his wife.
Listen, Mogra. How many times have I told you that I don't like less salt in my vegetables?
Sorry, I'll put salt in the vegetable immediately.
So much of salt. Are you going to kill me?
I'll put a little vegetable on it.
And look at this roti. This will break my teeth. Where from have I got such a wife?
But...
this hair. How many times have I told you that I don't like anything else in my food? Can you see this hair, Mogra?
I don't know. It would have fallen by mistake. It will not happen again.
If you repeat the mistake, I will take you to the barber and have your head shaved. Then I'm sure there won't be hair in the food.
Despite Tadkumal threatening his wife so much, what had to happen, happened. Tadkumal found a strand of hair in his food.
No, that would have come there by mistake. I comb my hair well in advance.
Go right now and get the barber here.
No, please, no, don't. Please don't. It won't happen again. Please don't get my hair cut. Don't get them cut.
Don't? Last time also you said the same thing. But there is a hair again. You will not improve till you get punishment. Come on, leave from here.
Listen, please.
When she realized that there will be no effect of her crying on her husband, she went straight to the barber. She told him everything. Then the barber said,
Sister, it's not possible even for me to explain anything to your husband. We will do one thing. Let's go to Birbal and see if he can provide us a solution.
Then Mogra and barber met Birbal. After listening to their story, Birbal said,
Now do exactly I tell you to do.
Mr. Tadkumal, please come soon.
Who is it? Oh, you barber. And where is Mogra?
I have sent my sister to have a bath. Without that, her hair won't get cut easily.
You did the right thing.
Now you also do one thing. Take this poison and gulp it immediately.
Poison? But why should I take poison?
You want me to cut your wife's hair or not?
Yes, so?
What do you mean so? Without you dying, how can I do such a thing? It is there in our scriptures. Come on. Get it over with that soon. Fast. I've called 4 persons to give shoulder and a man to carry the pot. And the pyre will also be ready at the crematorium. Now all the villagers too would have assembled there. Do it fast. Take the poison quickly.
No, brother, please.
Why not? Take it fast. Mr. Birbal has specially sent this poison with me for you. And what more? Your final procession will be in full splendor. You respect your religion so much, and that is the reason why the emperor will also take part in your funeral procession. You are indeed a very lucky man, Mr. Tarkuman.
No, Mr. Barber. I've committed a mistake. Don't punish me so heavily, please.
But even you were giving your wife such a heavy punishment, Mr. Tadkomal.
Yeah, you are very correct. My mistake, really my mistake. My anger never allowed me to think properly. Good that you have opened my eyes.
Who am I to open your eyes? That is the work of clever Birbal.
One day, Emperor Akbar was very angry with Birbal. He said,
What is happening here, Birbal? You gave medicine to clear the Begum's throat, and instead of clearing her throat, it has become worse. You heard how awfully she is singing? First, make her stop singing, or at least take her inside the palace.
My lord, what I felt was the best medicine, it was given by me to her. Sometimes some medicines do not give the desired effect, my lord.
But you should have said this earlier. The throat of Her Royal Highness seems to be an experimental place for you.
Our emperor has to pay the price for your folly. Japana, Birbal has to be punished for his mistake.
I agree, my lord. I accept my mistake.
Only accepting is not enough. He should be punished.
What Sher Khan is saying is right, Birbal. You should get punishment. What punishment should you get?
How can I tell you that? You have made the allegations against me. Hence, even though you are the emperor, you cannot take a decision on the punishment to be meted out to me, my lord. Yes.
What you say is also correct. Then who will...
My lord. If you do not have any objections, I will like to try this case.
Jahapana, in case of necessity, even I will try. It will only help the Qazi.
No. In our palace, people might already have been against Birbal. That is why the trial in this case has to be very clear. Otherwise, we will be unfair with Birbal.
Who then will try him?
That Birbal will decide.
But then he would prefer only those who are close to him.
Remember, till date Birbal has been fair with everybody. He understands the value of justice. Hence the person to punish him will also be decided by him. Tell me, Birbal, who would you like to choose for this job?
If you are insisting... In the outskirts of the city, there are a few people living there. I would be happy if they can give me justice, my lord.
What?
But they are illiterate people. How can they do justice?
My lord, they may be illiterate but are definitely not brainless, Mr. Sher Khan, isn't it? Huh? It is not necessary to learn any books to impart justice. Now, if you don't mind...
Okay. Birbal, if you insist, they will make out your punishment. Go and get them here.
Thank you.
Come on, move fast. The emperor must be waiting.
Look. Look at him, brother. He has put on full dress.
And look.
He's wearing shoes too.
Hey, who gave this to you?
Hey, keep quiet and look in front.
Do you all know for what you have been brought here?
We haven't done anything wrong. You see, sir, my lord.
Yes, your majesty, please leave us. We are innocent.
You have not been brought here for your punishments, but you have been brought here to punish Birbal.
Yes, my lord. But why are you doing this? What is our fault that you are punishing us this way? Mr. Birbal is a very big man. We have heard a lot about him. He has been praised by everybody.
On trial, by us, it's like he's showing a light to the sun.
Yeah, you're right.
My lord.
But Birbal himself wants you to punish him. So, his wish and my order. You have to read out his punishment.
But Bacha Salamat, what is the crime committed by Birbal?
Yes, what has he done?
Akbar told the three of them about the crime committed by Birbal and said,
Now three of you discuss amongst yourselves and decide on this punishment. Your justice will be accepted without any question.
Then the three of them started discussing with each other.
No. It is very difficult for us to punish a big man like
Birbal. But we have to punish
it is difficult. But what I say is that as Bacha has said, now we will have to punish Birbal very heavily now.
The emperor has given him a lots of more till now.
Yes.
Hence, he has to pay a total of 50 coins as fine.
Hey, what are you talking? He may be any big person, but see, he may be a minister, but first he is a human being.
Then how would he be able to pay such a hefty fine? So instead of that, we will fine him 25 mohurs.
Yes, correct.
And this way, he will learn a lesson. He will learn that kind of a thing again in his life.
He will keep thinking about us all his life.
Yes, you are absolutely right.
I think this is going to be very okay. Now, come on.
Let us tell the emperor.
Bacha Salamat. After giving due consideration to the situation, we have decided that the Birbal will pay a fine of...
Tell us. How much fine does he have to pay?
Birbalji has to pay a fine of 5 mohurs.
Five mohre.
And if he find it difficult, then he can pay it in installments.
This is going to help him.
The fine of 5 coins decided by the three of them was very negligible for Birbal. Hearing this, Akbar was surprised. And finally, Akbar appreciated Birbal for the idea he put in place to get his justice carried out. One day Hassan was giving a shave to one of the commanders. While shaving, Hassan had the habit of praising the person in front of him and also get benefited by the same. With the same purpose, Hassan tells the commander,
I will give you such a shave that even Sher Khan would be pale in comparison.
Buy some wood to burn in the fire.
My hands are very skilled in my job. Look this hat, please.
Who wants to buy some wood to be burnt? Who wants to buy some wood to be burnt? All are very straight, but one is little bent. Who wants to buy some wood? Please buy some wood.
Oh, oh, oh,
Hassan, what is this? Is this how good your work is?
This does not happen every time. That Gangaram who lives in the hills has come to sell his wood. Hearing his very unique and dirty voice, my hand slipped a little. You please wait here, I'll go and see him and come.
But your going out is not going to give my cat moustache back. Now remove what is left of the moustache.
Hassan removes the remaining moustache of the commander and comes out to deal with Gangaram. And he says,
tell me, Gangaram, how much will you charge me for all the wood on the donkey?
Oh, Khan Saab, what price am I going to ask you? You decide for yourself and pay me.
What I mean to say is, you would have thought of some price to sell the wood on this donkey, haven't you? Look, in business, these things are very common. Tell me, how much should I pay you? Tell me very frankly.
Is that so? If that is the case, I normally take 5 gold coins for this quality of wood.
Take these 5 gold coins and remove all the wood from the donkey, including the box, and keep it in that corner.
Khan Saab, the wood on the box is not the part of the wood for fuel.
Hey, but I had asked you the price for all the wood that was on the donkey's back. And I have paid you the amount you had demanded.
But Khan Saab, in our business we do not give the box containing the wood along with the wood.
I can't accept what you say. Gangaram, I had asked you for all the wood that was on the donkey's back. If your box is made of wood, what can I do? Listen, you have given your word and now you have to honor it.
But I earn my family's livelihood from this box, my lord. If you take away my box, what will I do?
Hey, if you give the box, you carry yourself. Carry the wood on your head.
No. Please don't do that, sir. We will then have to starve.
Look, Gango, you know it very well that I am the barber for the Emperor's family. If this matter goes to him, then you will lose both of your box as well as the donkey, eh?
Knowing that his protests would have no effect on Hassan, Gangaram put the wood along with the box in a corner. Cursing Hassan in his mind, he made his way back home. Gangaram was very upset, in great anger and clenching his fists, pacing up and down, he was muttering to himself.
It was all my fault. I should have listened to him carefully in the first place. But Hassan has also done injustice to me. How can such thing happen in business?
Seeing the restless Gangaram murmuring to himself, his wife asked,
Listen, what has happened to you? Why are you talking to yourself? You have sold the wood, haven't you?
Not only the wood, but also the box for the wood kept on the donkey's back.
What?
Gangaram narrated everything to his wife. Then the worried wife said,
Oh God! This is total injustice. You go to the Emperor's court and make a complaint.
But how can I do that? That Hassan is the family barber of the Emperor. For instance, even if the Emperor decides in our favor, there is every chance that the barber might make our lives miserable.
Oh God, if that is the case, then you meet Birbal. He is the one who treats everybody equally. That's what I have heard.
Yes. What you say seems correct.
Gangaram immediately met Birbal. He explained all the facts to him.
So that is the story. Gangaram, you please don't worry. Now do exactly as I ask you to do. Listen. Understood?
Yes, sir.
My lord, last time, because of the noise made by that Gangarab, your shave was not proper. I have taught him a nice lesson. I don't think he will ever show his face again. Forget about Sher Khan. Even the emperor will be stunned by your looks. You watch, huh?
Hasan Khan Saab! Huh? Oh, Hasan Khan Saab!
Hasan, what is this? Again the same mistake? I will never set my foot here again.
But sir, at least shave off the balance mustaches.
Leave it. I will get it done myself.
Hasan Khan Saab! Oh, Hasan Khan Saab!
Hey, what is it? Now what have you come for here? Last time I have already bought all your wood.
But I have not come to sell wood today, my lord.
Then have you come here to sell your donkey, foolish fellow?
Hasan Khan Saab, whatever happened last time was entirely my fault. Now let us forget that.
Come to the point.
I have a friend.
So have you come with his wood this time?
Oh no. My friend has obliged me number of times. It is because of him, me and my family are alive today.
Hey, sir, come to the point.
Sir, I wish that you give my friend a shave.
How nice of you, Gangaram. As you wish, you are talking to me as if it is the emperor's wish.
You are nothing but an ordinary seller of wood. And myself, I am the royal barber.
Why should I give a shave to a friend?
Come on, get out of here.
My friend has something special in him.
What is it?
Listen, anyone who gets to meet him, his future changes for better. Now look at me. Initially, I was very poor. I could not have even one proper med. Then I got him as my friend and my luck changed. Now I am leading a very happy life with my family.
Is it?
Yes. Now if you will give him a shave, who knows, even your luck will change for the better. Probably you could become one of the 9 gems in the emperor's palace.
Okay. I'll come. But I will not take less than 20 gold coins, Ganga.
Okay, you can take it right now.
After paying the money, Gangaram brought Hasan to his house. After making all the arrangements for giving a shave, Hasan said,
Ganga, come on, please call your friend now.
He is standing in front of you. You may start.
Ganga, I cannot see anyone here.
How can that be? Who's this? This donkey is standing in front of you. What if it is a donkey? It is a very, very smart, just like you. He will not trouble you.
Donkey?
Yes, donkey. He is my most beloved friend. And you have come here to give him a shave. Now start immediately.
Hey, shave a donkey and me? Never.
What are you saying, Hasan Saab? Sometime back you agreed that you will give a shave to my friend. Have you forgotten that? You have also taken money for it.
Yes, but I did not know then that you will ask me to shave a donkey. An ass?
What can I do if a donkey is my friend? You have accepted. You have to give this donkey a shave.
Who do you think I am? I am the family barber of the emperor. Insulting me is like insulting the emperor. I will now have to teach you a good lesson. I will show you who I am. You come to the emperor this very moment. Come on.
Saying so, Hasan took Gangaram to Akbar's palace and he said,
My lord, I have a complaint against this wood seller Gangaram, your highness.
Jahapanaha, even I have a complaint against Hasan.
Realizing that the situation would be tricky, Akbar said,
Birbal.
Yes, my lord.
Listen to them, what they want to say. Tell me, Gangaram, What complaint have you got against Hassan?
Not him, Birbal ji. I have a complaint against him.
Wait, Hassan. You belong to this palace, don't you? So we will first listen to what this common man Gangaram has to say, okay?
Okay.
Gangaram narrated the entire incident in front of everyone. Then Hassan asked,
Birbal ji, now please you tell me, can a donkey be a friend of a man?
Why can it not be, Hassan? In this world, anyone who is of some use to another can be friends with each other. Then it can either be a donkey or a man.
But Birbal ji, that his friend is a donkey was not told to me in the first place by Gangaram.
Who to take as a friend is best decided by the individual himself. How can we decide on that? And Gangaram had told you in advance that you will have to give a shave to his friend.
But how can a donkey be a friend to a man, my lord?
Why can it not be? If the box kept on the back of the donkey can be counted as firewood, then a donkey can also become the friend of a man. Am I correct?
Hassan was surprised by what Birbal said. He understood the trick played by Birbal and Gangaram. Softening his stand, he said,
I have made a mistake, Jahapna. Please forgive me. I have cheated on Gangaram. I am ready to return the box to him, my lord.
You will have to return the box, Hassan. But after giving a shave to Gangaram's friend.
So the turn came for Hassan to give a shave to Gangaram's close friend. All the people started laughing at him.
What a dream. God, why did I get such a dream? What could be the meaning of this dream? Begum? Hey, Begum. Begum.
What? What happened?
Begum, I'm feeling very uncomfortable.
What is troubling you?
Listen, I had a very upsetting dream.
You only had a dream. So there's nothing to worry about.
It's not like that. They fell off.
What?
Begum, my teeth fell off.
What? Your teeth fell off? Let me see.
No, Begum, not really. In the dream.
They only fell off in your dream. So let them fall. Now let me go to sleep.
Please listen to me.
Let me sleep now. Or I shall turn your dream into a reality.
Akbar could not sleep a wink the whole night, trying to find the meaning of his dream. At the crack of dawn, he told his servant in the palace,
"You go immediately and get all the astrologers in the city here. I have very important work with them."
"Your Highness, shall I get Birbal here too?"
"Just go and do as I order to you. Rest can be attended to later."
"As you say, sir."
The servant goes out into the city and gets hold of two astrologers and brings them to the palace.
"Your Highness, I could get only these two astrologers in the city."
"Okay.
Tell us, my lord, in what way can we be of use to you? Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya.
Panditji, last night I had a unique dream.
Unique? Then Guru must be playing.
Who is this Guru?
Not any Venus who lives here. Up there. I mean in the sky. Venus, Mars, Pluto, Saturn, you know. Let us understand what the Emperor has to say.
Yes, please tell me, Lord.
I dreamt that I had lost my all teeth except one. That is why I have become very restless.
Oh, restless. It means moon is at play.
Let it be. You please tell me the meaning of this dream.
Will you explain, Shukracharya ji, or should I?
If you wish to explain, please go ahead and do it.
Barring one tooth, the rest fell off, is it? Your Highness, what? Did you dream of this while you were awake or while sleeping?
It is a dream, Buddhacharya ji. It is seen only while sleeping.
Is it so? What I meant is, some kings have seen dreams even while being awake. This I have read in history.
Okay. Now tell me the meaning of this dream.
Yes, I'll tell. Barring one tooth, the rest fell off, which is the sun exalted, the moon in lower home, and Rahu is looking over. Huh? Inauspicious.
What?
Very inauspicious.
Ram.
All your relatives will die before you, my lord. And after that, you will have to live all alone. There is no solution to this problem, your majesty.
Panditji.
Hence, whatever comes up has to be accepted.
Fool! You're saying such unpleasant things to me despite living in my kingdom. Is this your knowledge? Wait, you shall be severely punished for this.
But your majesty, what I...
Listen, remove him from the kingdom and keep whipping him while doing so.
No, my lord.
Come on, Panditji. Whatever comes up has to be accepted. Take this.
Please look, Shukracharya ji. Please look into astrology book. Please let me know what you think is the meaning of my dream.
Bacha Salamat, I have brought the wrong astrology book by mistake, you know.
What?
I will go home immediately and get the correct astrology book. Then I will explain you whatever you want.
Okay. Come as early as possible.
Shukracharya ji, upon leaving the palace, went straight to Birbal's house. As only Birbal had the intelligence to answer the emperor's dilemma. Shukracharya explained everything to Birbal and he said,
Birbal ji, the meaning given by Buddhacharya to the emperor is the right one. And my teacher has taught me never to lie. Now what should I do? If I tell the truth, I'll be in trouble. And if I lie, I'll again be in trouble.
There is no reason for you to be worried, O learned one. Please give the explanation to the emperor exactly the way I tell you to do, okay? Come here.
Just tell the king that you...
When Shukracharya entered the palace, Akbar was very worried. The emperor asked,
Well, Shukracharya ji, have you brought the correct book?
Yes, my lord. I will tell you the meaning shortly.
Huh.
If one but all of your teeth have fallen off, it means Lord's grace, Sunny's grace, and Rahu's acceptance. Jahapna.
What is it?
What a dream you had! Great!
What?
Yes, my lord. One needs to be blessed to get such a dream, my lord.
What are you trying to say?
You are one in a million, my lord.
But what happened?
What happened? Jahapna, amongst all your relatives, you will live the longest. Very shortly, you will never have any kind of trouble from any of your relatives.
Huh?
Upon hearing this, the much worried Akbar said with happiness.
Shukracharya ji,
You are a very smart person.
It is all due to his blessings, Jahapna.
Sevak, give this man 2 pearl necklaces and 200 gold coins immediately.
One day Emperor Akbar, pleased with something that Birbal had done, said to him,
"Excellent Birbal, no amount of prize is sufficient to your deed. You are a quick-witted. Your sense of justice, I am very pleased with all this."
"You are very magnanimous, my lord."
"It is not so, Birbal. You really are the best. So I am giving you a gift of 200 gold coins of my free will. Please accept it."
"As you wish, my lord."
Seeing Birbal get a gift made people jealous of him and very angry. Among those who were jealous of Birbal getting a gift were the emperor's brother-in-law and his co-commanders, and also the Qazi. The Qazi wanted to bait Birbal and shut his mouth up, so he said,
"My lord, your minister is very clever. Wherever you go, you hear people praising him."
"Yes, that is true."
"My lord, today I am going to ask Birbal a very simple question. If he is able to answer my question, then I will agree that he truly is clever."
"Yes, you can ask whatever you want to."
"My lord, so many times must Birbal be seeing the hands of his wife. So, how many bangles are there in her hands? I wish he answers my question."
Not wanting the Qazi's question to blow up into an ugly debate, Akbar said,
"Good Qazi, a very excellent question. Till now, even I do not know the number of bangles in the hand of my begum."
"My lord, our Qazi is very intelligent in the subject of mathematics, and this we all know. And he also has the habit of running his hand through his beard, which means he would definitely know the number of hair he has in his beard."
"I hope you remember my question, Mr. Birbal."
"I'm only replying to that, Qazi sir. You see, the number of hair that you have in your beard, 1,000th of that number is the number of bangles that are there on my wife's hands."
"Well done, well done. Great, Birbalji, great."
Hearing Birbal's answer, the emperor and the others could not control their laughter, and the Qazi lost his face. But even Akbar felt like asking a question similar to that asked by the Qazi. If Birbal can give a reply, it will be enjoyable. And if Birbal does not, then Birbal will fail for the first time. If I can get away with my question, then it's good. Else I will get an intelligent answer, thinking this, Akbar said.
"Birbal, I have hair all over my body. But how is it I don't have any hair in my palms?"
Understanding that even the emperor has decided to have fun, Birbal said,
"What are you saying, my lord? You are very generous, kind and giving."
"So,
your highness, someone or the other is always receiving gifts by your hands. You distribute coins for charity. Due to this, there is constant friction that the coins create on your palms. The hair on your palms fall off, my lord. In such a case, how can there be hair in your palms, your highness?"
"What you said about me may be true, Birbal. But what about you? You don't give any charity. Then, where is the hair in your palms, Birbal?"
What you say is very correct, my lord. Mm. But like I told you earlier, you are very generous and kind-hearted by nature. My lord, you repeatedly get pleased and give me hands full of gold coins every time. And so the hair in your palms have gone by giving away those gifts. Similarly, the hair in my palms have gone by accepting those gifts, my lord.
I accept this point of yours too, Birbal. But there are so many people in the court. They don't have any hair in their palms.
Wow, great! What an excellent question asked by his highness. Now Birbal will be in trouble.
My lord, I was to ask the same thing.
Pardon me, my lord. But now you are forcing me to tell things openly.
Please tell.
Sir, every time you get happy with me and you always keep giving me gifts. But this is not liked by anyone in the court. Whenever you give me a gift, all these people out of sheer jealousy start rubbing their hands together. And that is why the hair in their palms have also fallen off, my lord.
The emperor was very happy with Birbal's reply and gave him an additional 50 gold coins. Once again, all the other courtiers started rubbing their hands out of jealousy.
There lived a short-tempered lady in Delhi. She would often scold her husband and repeatedly hit him with her slippers.
So, mister, did I not tell you not to keep the vessels here? It has to be kept in its place. How did it come here, huh?
I made a mistake. It won't happen again.
Mistake? So correct your mistake immediately.
Yes, yes.
When will this man ever understand? He has to be told about everything. Listen, you come here first.
Yes, I'm coming.
When will you clear the floor? After it becomes known.
I'll clear it. I'm doing it right now.
See, if I'm here, the house is running so smoothly. If I had left it to you, then this house will never be the same. It's good that I have the slipper with me.
Oh, God.
Bend more. Nothing is going to go wrong. Bend. This is a gift from the deity of my mother's house.
Yeah, I understand.
It's because of her that you are here.
But when did I ever deny it? Oh my God. Hey, slowly. A little softly, dear. What are you doing?
Thus, this woman, under the pretext of deity's gift, regularly used to beat her husband Daulat with slippers. And poor Daulat quietly took the beating. Similarly, one day, this lady, angered by her husband, beat him up soundly. Daulat too, like always, did not utter a word. Seeing this, his neighbor Mahipati took pity on Daulat. On seeing Daulat alone at home, Mahipati entered his house.
Daulat, why do you get beaten like this? Why don't you ever object to this?
But friend, she beats me for the welfare of this house. She beats me not out of anger, but out of love.
Out of love? What do you mean?
You know the slipper that she has? The deity of her mother's home has given it to her. Without getting beaten by that slipper, this house can never be in proper shape. This the deity herself has told her.
Look, you are doing all the household chores. Over and above, you are only getting hit. I can't understand this. Why don't you find a solution to this?
What solution will I get?
Dolat, you meet Birbal.
What can Birbal do in this? This is our personal matter. Why would he interfere in this?
Look, Dolat, you are a man. And if your wife does not even treat you as a man, it is atrocious. If you meet Birbal, he can guide you properly.
Dolat met Birbal and explained the situation in his house. Hearing this, Birbal said to Dolat,
Dolat, there is no deity which can give a gift to commit injustice. Whether there is any truth in the story of the deity of your wife's mother's house giving her such a gift, we need to find out, okay? Now you do exactly as I tell you to do. Listen.
Yes.
Understood?
Yes.
Hello? Are you listening?
Oh, have you woken up?
Huh.
Come here as fast as you can. See what I have got.
Huh? What has happened to you? Why are you worshipping this iron rod?
But this is not an ordinary rod.
Then?
Last night, Lord Hanuman had appeared in my dream. He was pleased with me and gave this iron rod as a gift to me.
What have we to do with this?
Oh, like your deity has given you a slipper?
The
same way is this rod. Like when you get angry and I get beaten with a slipper? Because of which our house is in proper condition?
Yes.
In the same way, when I get angry, you have to get beaten with this rod. Yes, by this our house will become prosperous. And we'll get wealth equal to that of the emperor. You can also strut around like a queen.
But whoever told this to you?
What do you mean who? Lord Hanuman himself told this to me. Come on, let's start using this rod immediately.
No, please, don't hit me. I will never get angry with you. And the gift from the deity is also a lie. It's a lie.
Lie?
Yes. My mother told me. She told me to do this to keep you in control.
So that's it. But this rod of mine is real. You understand?
I will never get angry with you again. And I will not hit you with the slipper again.
It's okay. Now move out. I have to sweep the house.
Please don't. I will do all the chores from today. You sit comfortably with your rod.
Hassan was the royal barber. That is why he was involved in trimming the hair of the emperor's family. One day Hassan went over to give a shave to the emperor's brother-in-law, Sher Khan. Sher Khan was one of the many nobles who was envious of Birbal. He had always wanted to be one up on Birbal.
My lord, I have never seen a person who is so shrewd in politics as you are in the whole world. Excellent.
Very right, Hassan. But I only look like a shrewd politician. Despite being the emperor's brother-in-law, I am yet to get a post.
How will you? You have the emperor's favorite Birbal, the ever-interfering. According to me, you should actually have been the minister. In fact, I say you will become.
Hassan, that is what I think too. But is it possible at all?
My lord, just say yes. I will hatch such a plot that Birbal will have to mourn and you shall reach the throne.
Hassan,
If only it happens, then I'll fill your pockets with diamonds and pearls.
My lord, with the diamonds and the pearls, along with the 9 gems in the emperor's palace, if you can make me the 10th gem, then I will be grateful to you for the rest of my life.
Sure. Sure, I'll do it. Now go. Get down to work.
As you wish, my lord.
As had been planned, Hassan got to work. He was very smart and cunning. On the appointed day of the week, he went to the royal palace to give a shave to the emperor.
Jahapna, while I'm serving you, I'm reminded of my father a lot.
Hassan.
Yes, Your Honor.
You're my family barber.
Yes.
Just like my father did not let you down on any issue, I shall also not let you down or anything.
May the Lord be blessed. My Lord, why would anyone lack anything in your kingdom? But
what, Hassan?
My Lord, I am very much worried about your father. Sir, he appeared in my dreams yesterday and he told me, Hassan, I am very happy in heaven here. But I am not able to pass my time very easily. So you tell my son to send a man to heaven, a smart, intelligent and quick-witted person, for the sake of my entertainment for at least 4 to 6 months.
My dear father, I'm not able to bear this condition of yours. I'll send a joker to you tomorrow itself.
Oh no, no, my lord. What are you trying to do? Of what use is this stupid gesture? Your father had asked you to send a quick-witted and intelligent person. Jesters are like stupid monkeys.
Okay. It is true. Then tell me, who do we send?
Jahapna, do you have anyone as smart and as quick-witted as Birbal in your court? Why don't you send Birbal then, my lord?
Excellent, Hassan. I'm very happy. Birbal, you're my loyal subject. I'm very sure that you'll fulfill my all desires.
Your Highness, I will fulfill any of your desires. I promise you that. Tell me, what is it that you wish me to do?
Birbal, my father had appeared in the dreams of the royal barber Hassan. He said that he wanted somebody to send for his entertainment. So my wish is that you go there.
Despite understanding Hassan's plot, Birbal told the emperor very humbly,
My lord, your father is in his heavenly abode. How can I go there?
Correct. I did not give this a thought at all.
My lord, this is very simple. Birbal is a Hindu. If he is burnt alive, then he will automatically reach your father in his heavenly abode.
Excellent. Hassan, what a great idea. Birbal, I am ordering you that you enter the funeral pyre today itself. For this, I will give your family 20,000 gold coins. Let the work begin.
When Birbal realized that there was very little escape, then he thought of an idea.
My lord, as per astrology chart, this is not the right time to enter the funeral pyre. So I shall enter the pyre tomorrow. But my lord, who will look after my work when I am away?
My lord, your brother-in-law Sher Khan can hold the post till then, isn't it?
Okay. Birbal, what do you think about it?
It is okay, my lord. As you wish, your highness. I'll start preparing for tomorrow.
The next day, as was decided, Akbar along with all the nobles put Birbal on the pyre and lit it. Once the pyre was engulfed in the flame, Hasan and Sher Khan were delighted. Six months had passed and the palace was full. Then suddenly a man with mustache and beard said that he was Birbal. Hearing this, everyone present in the palace was stunned. Seeing everyone scared, Birbal said,
"Your Highness, I'm Birbal, Your Highness."
"But you had gone visiting the heaven. Then how are you here alive?"
"Most intelligent Mr. Sher Khan, I have come back to earth with the help of a trick, huh? Which I shall not reveal to you."
"Okay, that's all right. But Birbal sir, please tell me, how did your mustache and beard grow so much? And are you not ashamed of coming to the royal court looking like this?"
"You should pardon me, Your Highness, but what could I do? I have come from the heaven. And in heaven, there is no barber like Hasan there. My lord, my beard is nothing. My beard has grown only this much. But the beard of Emperor's father has grown up to his hips."
"Huh?
Now what should be done?"
"What? So my father is suffering so much?"
"It is true, my lord. You think I'm lying to you? Like Hasan?" "My lord, your father, along with a quick-witted man, had also asked for Hasan to be sent to heaven. But Hasan, the barber, did not inform you of it, my lord."
"What? Hasan, why did you not tell this to me?" "You will immediately have to go to visit my father. Understood, Hasan?" "Birbal, you personally make the arrangements."
"As you wish, my lord."
As ordered by the emperor, Hasan was taken to the cemetery and was thrown in a pit. After that, Akbar asked Birbal,
"Birbal, I'm pleased with your loyalty towards me. But tell me one thing, how did you came back from heaven?"
In reply to Akbar's question, Birbal just chuckled. But he was very happy at the success of his plan. On the fateful day, Birbal, with the help of some soldiers, had dug a tunnel below the funeral pyre. When the pyre was lit, he had escaped using the tunnel. In this way, Birbal outsmarted the cunning Hasan.